Hello again and welcome back to Element 14 Presents. I'm Surbhika and today I'm going to show you how I build a capacitance meter for less than $5. Yes, you heard it right. It's not easy on pocket to own your own capacitance meter. So why not build one? Let's see how. Well, there could be number of ways to measure capacitance. It could be based on LC oscillator or you measure phase shift across a capacitor. But today I'm going to use 555 timer IC because they are almost abundant in the electronics market and pretty cheap as well. I'm not going for off-the-shelf ICs available because they are a bit expensive and it makes no sense to build an expensive capacitance meter for your own. Otherwise, you would just buy one. This is the datasheet of 555 timer IC and here we can see the functional diagram of its internal operation. The three resistors from VCC to ground form a voltage divider. These two are comparator circuits. So if a signal is more at its non-inverting terminal compared to the inverting terminal, the output is logic high. Otherwise, logic low is produced at the output. These comparator circuits control the operation of the SR flip-flop. Also, the transistor can discharge the load connected at pin 7 if the flip-flop output is high or when an external active low reset signal is given to the IC. The datasheet mentions three ways in which this IC can be configured. The first one, monostable operation, it generates a pulse output when trigger input is applied. On the second, astable operation means the IC can work as a free-running oscillator in this configuration. The capacitor charge and discharge times can be controlled using the time constant variables. This is a lot of information given, but what is most important to me right now is this relationship that says the period of oscillation is linear function of capacitance. I'm going to use this one. So if I fix the resistance values in this configuration and measure the time period of oscillation, I can get the unknown capacitance value, that is the only unknown variable left in the equation. I'm configuring the 555 timer in a stable mode of operation and going to verify that output is oscillating. Also that the time period of oscillation does changes with different value of capacitance. Having finished my timer circuit, I'm using Raspberry Pi Pico to capture the oscillating signal waveform. Raspberry Pi Pico has a 12-bit ADC with conversion rate of 500 kilo samples per second, so it should be able to capture the square wave properly using the MicroPython code. At the position of unknown capacitance, I'm connecting 10 microfarad capacitance and using separate supply for now. This is code for A to D conversion. I printed the values at console and plotting it, we see a good pulsating waveform. Let's change the capacitor to 1 microfarad and capture the waveform again. Yeah, we can clearly see the change in time period. So our proof of concept is working correctly.
Hi, I'm Derek, and this is DC to Daylight, where we explore the world of electronics in the realm of DC, audio frequencies, RF, and into the visible spectrum of light. Here we take electrical engineering topics out of the boring old textbook and bring them into life through demonstration and test. Sometimes we even build stuff, and if there's a way to test the concept at hand, we'll put it on a scope and measure it, and in doing so, hopefully bring it to daylight. So if that sounds like a good time to you, come hang out with me every couple weeks here at Element 14 Presents. All right, see you there.
Using ADC to measure time period is a slight overkill, so I'm still going to use Raspberry Pi Pico, but with its interrupt handler. The handler function increments the counter every time it sees a rising edge. I will essentially count the number of pulses per second, that is frequency of oscillation, which is inversely proportional to time period, so almost the same thing. When I run this code, I see number of rising edges counted by the interrupt handler in a second, which is my waiting period. I still need to calibrate this number to show accurate capacitance values on display. This is a 16x2 LCD to display the measurements. I have already soldered wires to its pins to connect it easily on the breadboard, as you see. This LCD is run by ST7032 controller, which can be interfaced with Pico over I2C protocol. I'll just do the connections for I2C interfacing quickly. Removing the external power and now driving the timer circuit as well as LCD using the 3.3 volt supply from Pico. I also modified the interrupt handler code to include LCD logic as well, and when I run it, it displays the value of capacitance in microfarads. The circuit so far developed was on a breadboard, so I transferred all of that to this PERF board. I also calibrated the capacitance values using an experimentally calculated multiplying factor. I'm so excited to test this board now. It's finally demo time. So you see, I'm able to measure capacitances quite reliably with this board in a very low budget. Although there is some threshold value below which we cannot measure with this board because of the internal capacitance of the IC itself and also the parasitic capacitances which we have not considered. So if you want to improve on the lower range of the capacitance value which we can measure with this board or the precision of the device, then you would need to apply compensation techniques or use other methods. I really enjoyed making this project. I hope you enjoyed watching it as well. So if you have any more queries about this project, you can contact me on Element 14. Thank you for watching till the end.